know that executive function is an area of concern in fetal alcohol spectrum disorder. Many, many studies have shown this. Carmen Rasmussen, 2005, individuals with FASD display many deficits in the area of executive function. These deficits can lead to lifelong difficulties adapting, functioning in society. Specifically, EF difficulties can result in problems with planning, etc. So we know it's seen as a primary deficit in this group. But we need to kind of discuss and pull apart what that really means. Originally, executive function was a term that we used in cases that we followed who had brain injury. Almost all assessment of EF historically was in patients with either stroke, aneurysm, or traumatic brain injury. And it was actually not even considered a child cognitive ability, as because when I trained in the early 1990s and late 80s, the word at that point was, well, we don't really talk about executive function in kids because really the frontal lobes aren't doing anything. They're just sitting there waiting to come online and, you know, just kind of hanging out, and that part of your brain's not being used yet. And that was the same wisdom of the, oh, you only use 10% of your brain kind of idea, that they just weren't doing anything yet. So no one would have talked about executive functions in children at that time because we didn't think that they had developed or there would be any reason to discuss them. And it was a very narrow construct. And it was through behavioral manifestations of executive functions that we basically came up with this idea that what executive function is something that includes basically this ability to organize and also something to do with novel tasks. When I have to face a situation that I haven't faced before and organize my behavior to deal with it, okay? So both novel tasks and organizing were felt to be important in this construct. What does the term currently mean? Well, I pulled this off of Wikipedia. That seems like a good, reliable reference. Executive functions is an umbrella term for cognitive processes that regulate, control, and manage other cognitive processes, such as planning, working memory, attention, problem solving, verbal reasoning, inhibition, mental flexibility, task switching, and initiation and monitoring of actions. And actually, that's not a bad definition in that it hits many of the major components that a lot of people talk about with executive function. We often use a metaphor as well. You'll hear metaphors like, well, the executive functions are the CEOs of the brain, or they're the conductors, or the directors, or the pilot of our behavior. And these are nice metaphors. They're very easy to share with families for them to get a sense of where the problem is. But they kind of imply that there's some little guy up there who's making the decisions. Make more widgets. So it kind of gives us this kind of man behind the curtain approach that probably isn't very realistic in terms of actual underlying brain function. And indeed, as a result of it, we need to caution ourselves because it could become the new what is intelligence. it's a broad construct that becomes so wide that it becomes very difficult to use meaningfully. And it gets hard because certainly whenever we do sort of problem solving, there's a tendency to want to say, oh, that's executive function. But I want you to keep in mind that typically executive function is when something is novel or new or requires some level of organization. So not every task is an executive function task, or if it is, we're kind of in trouble because then the construct doesn't become very meaningful or very useful for us. So in general, definitions support that the general executive functions are viewed as sort of this multi-dimensional framework of cognitive abilities that provide critical support for goal-oriented and future-oriented behaviors. These behaviors typically include abilities including things like self-attention, regulation, inhibitory control, working memory, set shifting, cognitive flexibility, and some sorts of cognitive efficiency and planning. And the multiple dimensions of executive functions are embedded within conceptual models that vary in terms of the number of factors we think underlie them. From one factor in children and preschoolers, we only think it's one thing at that age, to as many as six from some people's studies. So, not to fear, I think there's some consensus, but I think what it does mean is that when you think about executive functions and when you think about the behaviors that the kids are engaging in, that you should think carefully about what it is about the behaviors, and as you observe things, what it is that's happening with the child, as you look at their behavior to determine, okay, is this an executive function, or is there some other piece that might be in play in this particular behavior? And I just think it's important to keep that in mind.